some music on. This is by staRpauSe. He's really cool. Makes good music. Creative Commons. He also has like a ton of other albums. All Creative Commons. And you can get them like $52. Which is pretty good. It's a steal. It's a steal even. Okay. Let's get straight to the biscuits. So, where were we last time? Let's go to DOSBox. Yes, I have in fact compiled DOSBox so I can debug it. Our last problem was basically unable to connect the serial port. Also, I found out that this was set wrong, so it wasn't mounting the CD. So, let's go through serial ports again. Because I debugged this pretty hard, and I feel a bit stupid. Wikipedia, are you real? My internet, please. The one time I need you, Wikipedia, you have let me down. Oh, is this a DNS issue? Fix another thing in my stream. Where are you? Does that fix it? No? Do other websites load? Alright, so it's, oh, here's Wikipedia. So, I'm not sure what's up with that. Maybe, hello! Hey Pigspoke! What's up? Is it morning there? It's like 6:40 here. Serial modem, null modem. So yeah. Last time I had an issue with DOSBox, I was trying to connect a serial port to it. And for 10:40, is that AM or PM? How'd your Java stuff go? So I had a direct serial connection to devputs 5. And then I think I just, there, I think that would work. So if I echoed, so if I connected DOSBox up, it should be able to talk to, that terminal. So if I go to terminal here, and run term.bat, it should actually let me just type to it. Yeah, see, so it shows up here. And if I echo it, today might actually be the start of it, now that I've kind of fixed the serial port issue, which I'm going to explain. So yeah, as you can see, it works with the terminal program here, but if I actually quit out of this, and I do something like type com3 and echo something, it just doesn't get the actual, it doesn't transfer anything. What am I doing there? So it seems that only terminal can access the serial port that's connected to DOSBox, and I sat and I thought about this for a while, and even last stream I actually brought out a serial port, but I made a mistake because my serial port was one of these. And what DOSBox wants is a serial port that actually connects everything. Including, let's go through the registers here. So DOSBox wants all those, particularly it wants to do hardware handshaking with request to send, clear to send, etc. It seems that the reason no one else has actually hit this problem is because the network null modem cable actually does transfer this. Like, you can connect two DOSBoxes together over the internet and it will in fact have it like working serial ports. But if you actually use the PTYs in Linux like I am now, it won't. So the solution to that is actually buried somewhere in DOSBox's source code. If we go to... what file was it? Source hardware serial port. Let's quit out of DOSBox here. Out. Away with you. You'll see right here, actually, that when it wants to write data, it runs putcar, and then that will just actually loop until it gets the proper registers. So what we would want to do is have it so when it tries to read the registers, it just reads loopback registers like this. So this pink line and this orange line. What's interesting is that DOSBox actually has the capability for this. It has a loopback cable. So I'm just gonna... it's not actually enableable by the actual... I think it might be a bug, but you have to force it enabled. So if we actually do that, and we do... a quick compile for that. And then we run this uses a different thing, but it's still opening the right serial port. Dev puts 4. Now I'll do the end of it. Now, if I actually do this, echo 1 to com1, and then type com1, it gives me 1 back. So it's now actually doing the handshaking and all that kind of cool stuff. But this loopback cable is actually completely useless, because not only does it loop back the proper registers here, it also loops back the receive and transfer lines. So, like... it actually is just a port that connects back to itself. However, we can actually patch it to be useful, so we're going to quickly do that. And we're going to do that by going to DOSBox's source code, opening up the serial port code. Oh, I already have it open in the program. Yeah. So we're just going to find the part where it decides to loop back the TX and RX lines. Why is that? That is in the wrong window for me. So the actual thing is here when it goes to write it, it checks if it's looped back and then it loops it back. And we're just going to if zero that. And then we're going to find the part where it receives it. Byte transmitted. And we're just going to if zero that. And then we're gonna make it again. And we're going to launch DOSBox again. And it's connected to the serial, so what we're going to do now is type we're actually going to echo something to it, like echo hi to com1. Did it not open? Opening puts 3. Type something into that. Test. Alright, right, test. Maybe it's COM 3 in this. Yeah, serial 3. Alright, so we go echo hi to COM 3, and it shows up here. And if we type something, then we do type COM 3, and then we quickly hit enter, it should bring it up. It might not actually be doing that because I compiled it wrong. Alright, let's quickly check the code. I might have missed something. So we're going to quickly find loopback. If not loopback. So we're going to set that to 0. Oh, that should be 1. These are just registers, so we're actually going to try and find the transfer stuff again. Get car, that should work fine, that should work fine. It should... I'll just undo everything. Okay, so this should be true. Let's find the next instance of loopback. Yep, that one's fine. Wait, is this one fine? No, that one's fine. Trying to find the ones that only interact with transferring. Skip that part. Okay, byte transmitted. If it's loopback, then it's going to set event, otherwise it's going to transmit that. So we're just going to go 0 for that. Oh, where was I just now? Right, transmit holding register. If it's loopback, it's going to set the event, so we're going to put that as a 0. Going to find... If it's not loopback, set break, so that's going to be a 1. I think that's all of it, so let's try another make. Hopefully I've got it right this time. So it echoes it there. What if I'm just doing it wrong? Because I didn't use cat before. Let's do type COM3. There we go. Okay, so we have serial port going in and out using the DOS functions, which is pretty good. So we've basically made DOSBox emulate this. There's a little bit of trickery. So the program we had before, which was my sanity check, which would just read from COM3 and then write it, now should work just fine. Yeah, it's a bit weird. I think that's because I messed up when I was writing it. And that crashed DOSBox, I think. Wow. Why? Oh, damn, that actually crashed it real hard. Hey, Joy Heard. Oh, gotta kill dash 9 it. So the other problem I was hitting is that in the DOSBox code for the PTY layer, if we go to this weird piece of code, sometimes Linux is sending 2 FFs in a row. And this confused me so much. I was like, why would it do that? It should never do that. You know, I wrote a quick program that actually opens up the PTS I'll show you, like, it doesn't seem to do anything. Like, if I do that, it opens it up, and then if I echo, if I printf these characters to it, it's like, oh, there's only one FFF. However, DOSBox is actually setting up an option called parmrk on the PTS. So if I set that from Linux and do that again, all of a sudden it's like, hey, let's have two FFs. It's like, Linux, why? Why it gotta be like that? And so, if I actually find the file. When it goes to initialize the terminal, it actually sets it here. So that's just, that's the big headache. That's all the headaches done. So the next headache to tackle is that I have my little serial port open. It's got a bin DOSBox. Oops, it's the wrong file. Nope, I'll get it right. So I read from COM3 and I print it. I think I actually wrote the wrong thing here, but we're just going to use the assembler to figure this, the debugger to figure this one out. So it's going to read, when it runs the DOS interrupt, it will actually read from the serial port there and buffer it. So I'll have to actually quickly print something to it, like test. Okay. Is that gonna work? Okay. Oh wait, that's not the right one. Okay, then if we go to the memory address of DX, it shows my input, it's test, how amazing, we've done it. We have sent stuff from a serial port in the DOSBox. We have the technology, we did it. And then hopefully this should like write to the screen, but it doesn't, so that's DOS interrupt 40. Yeah! Wait, is DOS interrupt 40 the one I'm looking for? Oh, I have to set my search engine to DuckDuckGo, otherwise Google's gonna dox me. Because every time I Google something, it's like, we're using your location, it's accurate. And I'm like, Google, please. Please, I beg you. But Google just don't care. Even in private browsing, it really wants to show me, like, if I search up some word or something, it's gonna be like, oh, you wanna go to a shop like that near you? Here's a shop near where Jookia lives. And I'd be like, nah. So, DuckDuckGo, you're the search engine today. No, I don't want to install your scary add-on. Okay, so DOS... How do you make money then if you don't store any information? Have you figured something else out that the internet doesn't know? So that was actually interrupt 40, which I believe is actually write file. So that should be writing back to the serial port. Hmm? Did it actually write com to the serial port? Why would it do that? What's DX at? Oh, I moved the wrong address to DX. Okay. So why does it crash? It doesn't? Why? What's... I don't understand. So... let's just do a quick cat, and then we cat it back. See, this does not fill me with hope. It DOS area II raf? Ignore? What? Why you do that? It read test, and it wrote it. And now it's doing something weird when it returns from the program, I think. Either way, our most pressing problem is that if you've noticed, if I do something like this, no input, and if I echo something to it and wait a bit, there's no input. So DOS isn't buffering the input. So if I'm going to run my program and then be like, I'm going to read some more lines, it's just going to skip the ones that were sent to it while it was doing anything interesting, like calculating how cool people are on Twitch. So apparently the solution to this is to use interrupts. And that means setting up the interrupt table or something. So we're going to figure that out today, hopefully. I went to this website called OS Dev, and it's pretty good. God, my microphone, I'm sorry. It's the worst microphone in the world. So if we go to the interrupt descriptor table, whenever your computer or DOSBox is like, hey, we got some data for you to do, the computer's like, okay, I'll do something now, right now about it. And that's called interrupts. And so the idea here is that when there's a character on the serial bus, the serial port, we're going to quickly write it somewhere and then resume the program. So it's a bit like multitasking, but no, it's multitasking, basically. So what is the interrupt descriptor table? Let's just open up Insight. And let's look at the memory of 0000. These are all the interrupt stuff. These are the memory addresses for interrupts. I think it's the first 400. First 256 words, I think. Not sure what it is on DOS. Location of IDT is kept in the IDTR register of the CPU, which can be loaded slash stored using the LIDT SIDT instructions. So what does that do? I'm looking for the interrupt vector table because I'm in real mode and we don't have protected stuff. Of course not. So yeah. There's the segment and then there's the offset. Segment and offset, but shouldn't that be bigger than that? Oh no, that's counting bytes. So if we go here, interrupt 0 is going to be at... it's a little Indian. So that should be like at segment 44C7 address 0006, I think. So divide by 0, that's what happens when you divide by 0. What else do we have? So that's CPU stuff, reserved. User definable starts at 020 to 0xff. And there's hardware ones. This is the one that we're actually interested in this interrupt here. Interrupt. OX, interrupt OC. So we're gonna fire some code when we get some data on the serial interrupt. So that's like 30 in the offset. So if we head on over to DOSBox land and we go to... why is that so high up? I want to go to 30. That should be around here. So that should happen when the serial port gets data. I don't think it does anything at the moment. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a software interrupt of our own that we can test with. I don't know how to do this. It doesn't seem that there's a clear mapping of interrupts. Or is that just by the number? Oh no, it's by the number. So let's try setting interrupt XFF. Okay, that's going to be our test interrupt. So we want code to run when we interrupt XFF. So let's quit out of here. Go to our seriously somehow broken basic Hello World program we have here. I don't know what I did, but I have failed, and I've managed to fail in a way that I don't quite understand. So we're actually just going to copy this file and make a new one called interrupt.asm, because I don't want to deal with that trash fire. I know commenting out code is cool, but I can't deal with having everything commented. So what should we do? We're going to have a busy loop. Remove this junk. Exit with success code. So we're going to actually have a busy loop. I don't know what we're going to do on the busy loop. I mean, I guess we could just empty a register. That seems like something to do. Sure, why not? Can we make a DOS program that goes forever? I don't know. I don't know if I can make it an infinite loop. That's how unconfident I am with this setup. Why did I name it loop 2? Just name that busy loop. And for the rest of time, it's going to do that. Okay, let's run that. Loop busy. How do I fail so bad with that? Okay, I did it. The program loops forever and crashes DOSBox. That's exactly what I want. So, we're gonna make it so. I don't actually know why I wrote that. Since I'm doing a different interrupt. That'll come in handy for later when we're testing the serial interrupt stuff, because that's actually going to be multitasking. So I'm just going to ignore that for now. And we're going to have it so we're just going to interrupt there. What happens if I make a false interrupt like that? Is that going to crash anything? I guess so. Is it? What? Okay. I'm actually just going to start running you under GDB, just in case. So, interrupt... Oh! What must have happened is that it went to the wrong place in memory. So, we're actually going to need something to do when the interrupt happens. So, let's just make... exit. And we're gonna do a bit of this in the debugger. So we're gonna start with something just boring happening there. Interrupt the debugger, then exit the turn. Yep, that seems completely like a fine thing to do. How do I compile this without running it? Control F. No, I don't want the key mapper. Save, exit, is that what I want? What's the secure site? Illegal group for call 3? What did I do? I'm sure if this was like a real DOS machine, my computer would be on fire right now and I'd just be shrugging. Like, oh no, I tried. Ah, that's because I put EAX in and I'm in real mode. Okay, let's quit out. Okay. Time to load this up in the debugger and hopefully connect the interrupt so it doesn't crash itself. So we got the sort thing. It's going to run in FF. And when we run into FF, we want to run this memory location. B8. No, wait, that's not the location. That's the, it's 0104, but we're at code segment 0EOA. So let me just quickly write that down. By the way, if you ever want to know how to quit Vim, open up Vim. It tells you, like, right here. It's sweet. It's like some kind of relationship where you're like, I don't know if I can go back to the person. But when you do, you find out you can leave at any time. Holy sh**, that's really dark. That's really bad to say. I'm sorry. What the hell? I'm half asleep. Abusive relationships are really bad. Okay, so we're going to go to 104. Now let's go to the interrupt table. Where am I going to write this? So the segment and the offset. So if I want to go to the interrupt, it's going to be FF times 4, probably. BFC. Yeah, that makes sense. So let's head on down to nope, that's not the place I wanted to go. Oh, yes it was. Okay. 3FC. And we're going to write in our memory address, which should be, if I can remember it, OAOE 0401. Okay, that seems completely fine. Now let's go back to my actual program, which should be at, is it PC? No, it's IP. It's code segment IP, I think. Yeah, why is it not going there? Oh, no, it is. Okay. Gonna go, gonna interrupt FF, and it should quit the program. It is not quitting the program. You have anything to tell me, DOSBox? No. Okay. Let's try and figure this out. What if we edit .com, just to actually store the address at the proper memory address. So let's see, move. Where are my registers? Let's put some more music on. I think I'm on at 386. So we should have source index, destination index. So we'll set the, I think it is the destination, yeah. So let's move the 0 into the destination index, and let's move exit return. What was it? What was my math? 0 times FF times 4, I think, in the hex. So we have C. Let's see if that compiles. Invalid off when it's move. Oh, wait. Maybe I have to move them backwards. That would make sense. Why do I have a clock in the top right? I don't know why it's messing with me. I guess if you're programming in DOS, you need a clock. Hey, Coz! Ross, what's up? You know why my x86 move instruction isn't working? Is it? Is this better? It uses one of those, it uses the flat assembler syntax. So if we go over to the flat assembler manual, which is here, and if we scroll down to the Turing complete movement stuff, general register to memory. Oh, these killer tunes are the staRpauSe Weekly Beats of 2018. They're CC BY. If you like them, you should, like, buy them. They're pretty sweet. Why are you making it in assembler? Says Troy Hurt. Because I haven't made anything really in assembler before. So I'm like, why not start with DOS? Seems fun. I think I'm actually gonna have to... CC by, I see CC by Y. Oh, I see. I get it. Sensible shuttle. Destination index. So I should probably put the memory address into the accumulator. And then I can dereference that. You know what? Does that number look a bit big for an accumulator? No, wait, it's 16-bit. Write it in C and compile it for DOS 486, then you yoink the disassembled code. I might end up having to do that with some more complicated stuff. But I don't think there's any really good C compilers for DOS, are there? This song sounds just a bit too anime. Reserve word used as a symbol. Oh, okay. So I don't put... Reserve word used as a symbol. Now, I read exactly something about this. And I forget it. Is it changing it to that? Is that fixing it? No. Okay. You've got the Dragon Book? What's that like? Should I read it? I think it's because I can only move to BX. So let's try switching those around. You wouldn't recommend? Oh, something happened. Nothing good, apparently. But something happened, it compiled. So it's... Yeah, I've read some of the SICP. But, I don't know. I'm writing a fourth. And it's happening. Move to BXAX. So if I go to BX... If I go to DIBX... And I do that... That didn't set the value to what I want it to be. Where did that move it? DS03C... DS... Wait, what are you telling me? DS03... Okay. So it's not the destination index. Oh! I'm an idiot. Okay. I should be putting... Data segment should be 0, and... I don't know, why did I... Let's try this. Move data segment. Does that help? Did I just get my wrong? DS. DS03FC. I have to set the data segment to something. What's the line number? Oh, the errors. Yeah, that would actually be kind of helpful, but I guess we don't have that technology yet. Why is this? Move data segment. Invalid operand. So, is DS not a valid operand? No. So, how do I set the data segment? Yeah, it's 2019. Computers are still in their infancy. Use V and AS IMO, says Troyhead. Yeah, I'm writing my current fourth in that. I'm using a GNU assembler and Vim and a bash thing to bootstrap it. DOS set CS. I want to set my code segment. No, I should be checking here. Move. Something to segment register. Do I have to move something? Okay. This microphone. I'm gonna die. I'm just gonna die. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it. Move AX. Let's try that. Okay, so I had to move it to a register first. No, you're dead. Okay. Well, something happened. Cisco architectures were a mistake. Yeah, I mean, I think it's hard to argue with that. I know that CISC is like, oh, it's easier to write assembly in, but it makes more sense to me to just do load store. Like loading stuff between registers and then storing it in memory. That just makes more sense to me. Okay. DS03FC equals 000. Okay. I understand that. But I also don't, because I'm telling it to move. No, I do. I just moved AX wrong. Okay. You should be going here. 6502. Yeah, that might be next. But that's like 16-bit, so I'm just really not sure. RISC V is pretty good. I've really been enjoying RISC V. Yeah. Was x86 a mistake? Should we have gone with M68K instead? Who knows? You know? The world would never know. It's like an alternate history where less machines. Oh. Would that have been a better future? DS03FC equals 000. Okay, I think I'm actually like high at the moment because I'm just seeing the code that I've written. And I'm saying move AX to like where DS03FC is. But is it going to do that? Do I need to evaluate it first? Oh, yes I do. Okay. And then we run the interrupt and oh, it worked. Oh, sweet lord. Oh my god. Do we have a party thing? No. Okay, that's, oh, is it not working now? What conditions does it have to work? Oh, I was happy for a moment, but now I'm just confused, and I think that's the theme of writing stuff in DOS. It works in the debugger, so it's gonna work in production, right? That's how it works. So if I do that, it doesn't interrupt here correctly, but it interrupted before correctly. Like, you saw it right, it got to the C drive prompt. I swear. It worked. Okay. Load IP. Are you busy looping CPU? Is this better? Okay, let's see. Did I run out of beats? How? Is my internet dead? Where are my beats? Did I go through all the beats? No. No, what's happened to the beats? I don't understand. This is illogical to me. Play some Chalga. I don't want to get sued by the Chalga industry. They're very cutthroat over there. It's how you end up in a dumpster. Okay, so we have AX. Let's just go there. Let's go to DSBX. And it's going to move it there. I'm not moving the segment. That's my mistake there. My bad. I've moved. Does it say genuine intel somewhere? Is it ironic that I'm actually running this on Brahma, which is an authentic AMD machine? No, it slaps the roof of this, look how much x86 I can fit. Oh. I think it says a lot about x86 in that AMD was the one that ported it to 64-bit, and Intel was just like, let's go make Itanium. This is going to be fine. Everyone can write code for a computer that's structured like a DSP. Okay, so we're going to move. So we've got... What am I actually doing? Yeah... I don't actually know how it works. Because it makes no sense to me. It makes sense to me, but it's like, surely there's something I'm missing. Let's see. Okay, statements, program structure. Bundles, is that what I want? I think, is there an example? Is there like a hello world here I can show off? I just really want to nail this home that this is... No one's actually writing assembly for it, which is a bit of a weird sign. Has anyone done this? Why? Sure. That looks kind of okay, but also hell. So, if I can't find it, I'll just explain it, but from what I understand, Itanium is actually programmed where you can write code that you write the multiple slots. It's like, imagine you don't have speculative execution, so you have to program it yourself, where you program each thread of the CPU and they run parallel. Like a DSP, except it's not because you have branching. I don't know how it works. It seems... Yeah, I have to... I really want to find it, so I might actually hop over to Google for a second. And we'll just see if it won't dox me. Itanium... Intel Itanium... assembly example. Writing efficient Itanium 2 assembly code. Okay, this is it. Remember, they ported Windows to Itanium, so you can use it for things. Oh my god. Maybe it's just a bad sign in itself, and that I can't find any like actual assembly examples for Itanium. Is this it? Anything, please. I want to use your architecture. Okay, that's what an Itanium CPU looks like. It's a classic slot 1, slot 2 design. Just shove it into your Pentium. 64 bits. Why would you not have 60? That dude. Show me the assembly. Oof. NAT supports speculation. You're explaining to me absolutely everything except the part that I hate. Is it being buried? Okay, so it's all about the parallelism. write parallelism stuff. You can't write parallelism stuff because it's dependent, so... Oh, can I actually find it? Assembler for Hello World. God, that looks terrible. What did you do? Oh. No, that's cursed. I wish I had a good example of it, but I swear, you have to believe me. But Itanium 64 is written like a DSP in some cases. And that's not what you want on a CPU, is it? Back to this. Okay, so we're gonna set the data segment to that. So we have BX. We're actually gonna set, we're gonna move BX to our code set, we're gonna set our code segment there, then we're gonna add okay, is this byte addressed? I'm getting mind blown. It's byte addressed, right? So if you add... God, what is wrong with me? Okay, let's just write BX plus 4 CS. Will that make sense? Can I do that? Well, I did do that. Oh, it should have been plus... plus 2. How do I get out of here? Welcome to DOSBox, where you're on the verge of crying. Okay, I swear I nearly have this. Please fund my blockchain startup. Sometimes I'm like, maybe I'll program on the blockchain. You know, it has smart contracts, it looks kind of fun. But then I look at it and I'm like, I can't afford that. I'm not rich enough to program on the blockchain. Yeah, it has, yeah, I mean, I want, where's that picture of like the UFO with the text I want to believe, because that's how I feel. Can't run code in this page? Why? What did I do? Oh. Okay. Let's go in and let's type insight. Yeah, it's just like, there's a lot of really cool tech, but also, it's not that cool. In fact, it's trash. But I'm like really gullible when it comes to cool tech, so I don't know. Okay, FE. Yeah, I'd also have to get past that. It's like, I want to write some cool stuff, and they're like, well, it's the free market. And I'm like, well, I don't have to have the free market, do I? Does that have to be part of my app? So, I mean, it would seem that my interrupt should in fact be pointing... Yeah, it's a pretty good song. It's up there. It's full of robot sex noises. Okay, so, my mind is breaking. I'm setting interrupt for F, the interrupt FF. And so my assumption is that it's going to look it up at 3FE, and it's going to set the segment here, And then do that, and then... This seems to be the right way that I'm supposed to write it, like, to memory. But then when I hit the button that interrupts it, it don't work. Why gotta be that way? Let's go back to OS dev and see what's up. It's the interrupt vector table. So there's the segment, and then there's the offset. Interrupt FF should be... That should be there. I mean, that seems like what it should be. But also, I feel like I'm in the bargaining stage, because this obviously ain't working. Yeah. It's pretty sick, ain't it? This sounds like the soundtrack is some weird, really weird 80s sci-fi movie. Did they even have back in the 80s, cuz? I don't want links, but I'm skeptical it happened. That's all I'm saying. Like, if it existed in the 80s, why is there no evidence of it today? OA. Okay. Oh no, I don't want you to. There's a vintage section on. Alright, how am I gonna get. Okay. No, why do you have to be. Why do you have to be like that over the window? Why can't I have the go-to window be somewhere else? Okay. O. O E O A. And that should. Oh. Yep. O E O A. 112. And that should put me here. It should run that. Is it because I'm not returning from the interrupt? Is that what I need to do? Am I actually like. Seriously messing things up? Do I need to return from the interrupt because DOS be like. I'm interrupted. I can't do this. Can't handle this. That seems like something that it would do, right? Okay. Interrupt. IRET. Oh, this song's pretty good. Interrupt. Okay, so maybe if I do IRET, then everything will work out fine. I'll have to rewrite some code for that. Let's say we're going to move BX. We're just going to set that to 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to return. And we'll set that to my handler. Oh, no. Not the can't run code on this page. Why? Why can't you do that? You know what? we're going to do this the right way, and we're going to debug DOSBox, because we're from the future, and we have the technology. We have the equivalent of JTAG. Those programmers back in the day, they had no way to debug it. They just shipped them off and hope it worked. Okay. So, how the hell do you... Where does DOSBox do its interrupts? CD source... handler. Rep. There's... So it installs a handler. Real set vec. Set real vec. I feel like I'm looking for the wrong thing. So what I'm just going to do is find the main loop. And we're going to go to run machine. Oh. Okay, pick run cure. It is okay C++. It looks like the C++ I would write. I just wish, like, does it have anything to do with interrupts here? It's dim as colors, and people like syntax highlighting. You gotta do it for the stream. It's the Debian defaults. Alright. Let's search for IVT. No. IVT. Maybe it mentions the interrupt vector table somewhere. No. Of course it doesn't. Why would it mention that in the code you're implementing? Why would you talk about something you're implementing? Why would you even mention interrupt in your code? Why would you... This has interrupts, right? I swear it has interrupts. Where is the interrupts? Ooh, I'm getting trolled. Ints. Is it in ints? Let's just go to int 10. Maybe that'll work. How do you do... Real set vec. Real set interrupt vector. Oh, could that be what it is? That seems to give me some results. The CPU / callback. Oh. No, that can't be the case. DOSBox wouldn't do something like that. No, it wouldn't. DOSBox certainly wouldn't hard code it so that all the interrupts have to go to C code instead of machine code. They wouldn't do that. That's not them. See? Run real int. It goes to the CB offset plus int num times 6. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna search DOS add software interrupt. And we're just going to, I don't know, give up on life. The first entry pointed to the IDTR is interrupt handler 0. IVT offset 00. Let's just quickly look through the memory here. So that would be divide by 0, and that would go to 1060 FOR. Nothing. What if it's at 1060? Is that what I wanted to see? How do I go here? Oh. This is the interrupt vector table, right? Should be, probably. Not sure anymore. The interrupt is typically located at the start of memory, and it's 4 bytes for each interrupt. Although it can be changed using the LIDT instruction, usually not done because it is convenient and incompatible. Okay, so it's probably there. The address of the interrupt is going to be at IDTR times 4. So my interrupt is 255 times 4, and let's put that in hex. 3FC. Okay. And then we set the segment and the offset. So if we go to 3FC. And then we look at where that is code-wise. What? Okay, yeah, so that moves something that it returns from it. So, that should be happening, yet it is not. Okay, let's just hit this again. And what's up, DOSBox? Run really int, int number equals 33. Okay, let's continue then break again. What? Oh, okay. I feel like I'm missing something big. But let's just hop over to frame 21 for a second. No, that's not helpful. I res. could it be that it's jumping there and I haven't pushed the program counter? Oh god. Okay, microphone, I need to fix you somehow. Is that gonna work? Nope. This was a bad idea. Oh, it might be a good idea. I think I did. Who says hair ties aren't useful? Hypothetical person who doubted me. Okay, let's go to the checklist. I can't get interrupts working. My handler doesn't get called. You need to call the interrupt. Oh, does it? Yeah, I keep it dry. Like Australia. We're going through some drought at the moment. It's devastating. It doesn't return. Don't try to return from an exception unless you solve its callers return. Pops everything you push but no more. Make sure you don't forget. Make sure it doesn't trash unexpected registers. For exceptions in hardware IRQ handlers, no registers at all must be modified. Could it be that I'm trashing the register, and then it doesn't like that? Probably not. That can't be it. Okay. IA32 mode. I'm in 16-bit. Yeah, let's head on to the forum. Who said you can't do OS development on Windows? That's pretty cool. See, I think the issue I'm hitting here is that these people are writing 32-bit code because they're smart. They're writing actual useful things. But I'm not. I'm writing stuff in DOS in 16-bit. Halt. What does that do? I've been meaning to look up that code. Halt. Until the next external interrupt. You know what? That's good. I like that. I'm looking at you, RiskV. You need the hold instruction, probably. Int number and RQs. Okay, so there's a keyboard interrupt. That's int 9. So let's just look at the... DOSBox probably has, like, all these interrupts predefined. Oh, FreeDOS might actually... That should be at 24. Let's go to... Oh, that's right. DOSBox is dead. Oh look, it's got the exchange. Yeah, do you have a better calculator that supports hexadecimal? Because that's all I have Python for. Jookia. Should I be sold on Jookia? What does Jookia bring to the table? Types. What do you use types for? Just use registers. I don't understand. This is so weird. Just imagine if I had types here in DOSBox. Can you imagine how efficient that would be? Yeah, DOS school, E98700FO. I have a feeling this is actually backwards. Because that seems... What is that? What is any of this? Is that code? 8789. There's no IRET here. Oof. Okay, so we're going to actually just... jump right into the terminal source code and see how they registered an interrupt. Oh. Why'd you auto-complete that then? Okay, edit terminal... RQ.ASM. Yeah. Expand it, please. RQ install. Push AX. Move AX into the... What's that IRQ buffer? RQ buff. No, okay. That's enabling the RQ. Store which interrupt we are hooking. XOR AX. It says it installs a handler here. Old vect plus zero. Yeah, this seems like this is exactly what I want. Kind of, maybe. Where's the old vect? Can this actually search multiple things, or does it just always show me the latest one that I have? Okay, we're actually just going to cheat and open up Vim and look at the code, because that is hell editor. Yeah, there's Vim in DOS, but it takes a while to load up. I don't want to load up DOS. It uses a DOS extender. Oh, I read it wrong. It's moving AX. What's ES and DI here? So move 0 to ES. Okay, what's DI? So it moves DI 4 + 8 times 4. And that's a 0CH. So let's open up Python 0CH times 4. 0C times 4. And that should be 48. And so what do they do there? Excuse me, I want to press the down button, thank you. Store which interrupt we are hooking. Push it. Move. Word. CLI STI. Do I need that? It's moving the offset using move word. RQ read RQ. And then it adds axe. Okay. And axe is the... code segment.
What?
Yep, okay, I get it now. I was reading the memory backwards. Oh, whoops. That should be AX. And that should be CS. I think. Let's see. I think I had the values switched around. So let's go to insight, send to int.com. Whoa! It worked! Int 15? Why is that int 15? Oh, that's why I've been having the big bug the entire time, because I didn't put a H there, of course. I hate H's. Yeah, we did it! The handler works. It works. Oh my god, it works. Oh. It's working. And this should make it quit with exit 1. Maybe. I don't know. So that's... I have a handler for an interrupt, and then I'm calling the interrupt, and it is doing something. And I did it. It happened. There's no other feeling than this when it comes to defeated DOS programming when you're your own enemy. Okay, so now we gotta hook that up to the serial port. Sure, that sounds fine. That sounds easy. How are we gonna do that? Okay, so what's the serial port? Yeah, serial. It's pretty serial, huh? That wasn't even a pun, but I said it as if it was. OC. For COM1, COM3. So let's see. Serial port is my mouse. Careful now, my friend. That's... I don't know if the Twitch terms of service allow that. 48. 0 times 30. So let's install the handler to that serial port. Oh, that's why I need to do the inhibit the interrupt, so I don't get interrupted before I've prepared. Vim. No, I'm not in the source directory. It's CLI-STI. Okay. So we're gonna run... Yeah, I need to make this part atomic. Or as atomic as it can be. So my handler would do that every time there's a serial thing happening. And I don't know exactly what it should be doing here, but I think I want to make a spin lock here. So in the busy loop, we're going to compare. Let's make a word. Mock int compare I think I'll just move AX lock and then I'll compare AX with that. And then if it's equal, it'll do that. And then my interrupt handler will store move lock. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. Oh no. I don't want my data segment to be that. There we go. That's what that's for. And let's move lock this one. Invalid operand. Okay. Alright. What? Move lock one. Okay. How does this code do that? Oh. Store memory. Okay. Operand size not specified. Move. Word. Yeah, I'll just have this be a word. Nope, that's an illegal instruction. I think it should be W. Nope, it is definitely not W either. So it would be term def. Nothing but stuff. Oh, it's dat. D word. DB. Should it be double byte? Or is it data byte? Just try that. Okay, so nothing is happening. And I can only assume that's because my code is working. And I need to print code into it. Nope. Nope, it's trash. CPU iret. Okay. Jump zero, is that a thing? Okay, that's pretty cool. So jump equal, so so if we look in the data segment for just 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, I think. Excuse me for a moment. Okay, where was I? So I want to look at where BX is. Oops, that is the wrong one. What is that? 30, yeah, okay. And so that should be going to 0E, 0A, 01, 23. Huh? What? How? 0E, 0A, 01, 23. Why is it going there? Why is it... Why has it decided that that's the place it's going to? Oh, okay. I see. It's moving the pointer in the interrupt. Word pointer 1. I should probably actually run that. What? Why is it set to 1? Oh, I'm not loading it. That's not how my life is supposed to work. Let's see. Remove that trash. Can I just do that? Does my dog want to come into my room? Yep, in you come, dog. Get under my desk where you belong. Yeah, under the desk. I can't move my chair back to my desk if you were just going to be there, okay? Please. Yeah, dog. Oh, do you want to go out of my room now? Is that what you want? You can go out of my room. This is now a dog stream. You gonna go out of my room? Or you just wanna... You just wanna stand there and look at me. Oh, you wanna pat. Okay. Okay, dog, let me explain the situation to you. I have a busy loop here, and I'm expecting an interrupt to set... to stop it. But it's not. Yeah, the dog is saying hi to me. He's a good dog. I think he just said to me that it's possible that it's because it's actually looping because I'm comparing it to 1 instead of 0. And I'll just check to see if that's true. He's just the dog, so he might not know. Yes, so it's gonna... Yeah, so this should actually... be 0. No? That's strange, because I'm comparing it to both things. And it should not be looping forever. Compare word lock with 0. Should it be compare 0 with word lock? Nope, it shouldn't be that, of course not. Yeah, you can hop up on my bed, dog. That's why he comes into my room, to get on my bed at night. Compare. So that should be setting various CPU flags, and then I should be able to jump if it's equal. Perhaps I actually have to load it first. So let's load it into AX. And then compare AX. Looks like we're gonna have to debug it. Okay, sets up the interrupts. Let's just have a quick data look at ESBX. And that should be set to 0 E or A. That's my program segment, 0123. Yeah, that's the correct thing. And then it should be getting the value into AX. I should set it to 0. Compare it. What is ZF and PF? Jump Z. Okay. And I suppose we're not having the correct interrupt. should be having interrupt 0OC. What if we set it to, I don't know, the keyboard instead, 09? Do dogs know everything? I don't know. Could be true. Oh! Huh? That seems promising. Int.com, and then I press a button, and nothing. It just crashed then, but it's not crashing now. See, I think this is actually a problem here, because it shouldn't be jumping. Should it? Oh, it should be. So let's just, let's set it to one by default. Nope, it crashes. Why are you gonna do that? Don't be like that. Maybe the assembler is crashing. Okay, dog, you can leave my room now. You have decided you've had enough people time. You may exit the room. Let's try this. So, I'm putting myself in a busy wait situation, and it just ain't gonna leave it. So, that might be issue number one on my list. So, let's move that back to 30. Lock should be double word 1, and it should not be succeeding in comparison. Ah! I have my crappy interrupt code in it to run my interrupt that is no longer there. Calling an interrupt that doesn't exist is how you get bad times, I believe. Okay, so let's set this back to this. What was that? 24. So when it hits the keyboard, the program should quit. Yeah! Check that out! It's also kept itself registered, so I can't press the keyboard anymore. But it's working, maybe. It's pretty good. So now I just need to set it to 30. And see if it's going to leave when it gets something on the serial port. Nope. It does not. Black Morty, programming in assembler in 2019. Wow, much respect. Yeah, it's, I like assembly. I don't like this assembly, but some assembly is pretty good. This is trash assembly. Let's see. No, not Sam 2. So, interrupt 30 is not firing. It should be firing. I have a trick up my sleeve for this. I'm actually just gonna break DOSBox on when it's running the interrupt. Pick unqueue. Okay, let's just... Next. Why are there so many threads? I don't want all these threads. Next. Let's just check out what frame this is. Info locals. Info entry pick event. What's entry pick event? Entry value. 22. Is this interrupt 22? Is that what that means? Are you lying to me, DOS? Let's see if 22 works. Because I got nothing. Maybe it really be like that. What's 22 in a hex? 16. This is probably going to be fine. It is probably not fine. This is not fine. Okay, so... what are the possible comm interrupts? Let's check out the code that works again. Let's see. So we're going to be using COM port 3. Do we have to enable interrupts? Do we have to enable IRQs? That seems like something we should do, right? So we have the right point, where the repeater. What port are we using? 0. RQ4 is 0C. RQ4 is 0C. What do you mean interrupt 4? Oh, RQ4 is interrupt 0C. IQ4 for COM1, COM3, else it's IQ3. So we're at COM3, so we're going to be at interrupt 0C. So that's confirmed. So I'm obviously not doing something right here. So, the bit mask for 8259 RQ4 enabled. I am feeling a little bit of regret, I'm not gonna lie. In fact, I'm feeling quite a lot of regret now. Okay. FIFO feature. Okay, I think I don't need a lot of this. I think we need to get the 8259 to enable the interrupt. And what is IODLY? Okay, programming with the 8259 pick. Real mode. So I have to send it a command. I don't want to enter protected mode. Okay, so how to mask the IRQ. Port equals pick one data. Are we under number 8? I don't want gladly. Okay, we're at IRQ 4. No, I'm just reading some C right now, Black Morty, because it's telling me how to set some ports. Okay, value equals NB. Okay, so I want to quickly just read in the current IRQ mask. So it is that port. That would be pick one. 20. So I'll just write. Port 20. Wait, is that 2020 or hex 20? Hex 20. DOS is mono trace. Treath? Mono. I don't quite understand what that means, Black Money. Should I look that up? Port, pick one data, pick, oh, did I write data? Pick one plus one. Okay, so pick one data is gonna be 21. NB port. Okay, so how do we do the NB? Did you know that x86 has ports? Isn't that interesting? DOS? Oh, DOS is single threaded. Is that a problem? Not really. Right now we're kind of doing a kind of interrupt based thing, so it's kind of multi-threaded. It depends on what you say threads are. Like, all CPUs are kind of single-threaded, but the OS switches between them using interrupts. Okay, so let's see. We want to go in AX021, and we just want to read that and see what's up. Nope. Yeah, did I write that? So the interrupt mask is F8. You what, mate? That's a bit mask, right? And... ooh... let me just quickly open up my calculator. Bin... what's the value? F8... oh... and the IRQ that I want is 4. Yeah, so that's definitely not enabled. How the heck am I gonna do a bitwise operation? Oh. Spooky music! Are you spooked? I feel a little spooked right now. What's four? Oh! What? Is it enabled? One shifted by the IQ line. Oh, it might be enabled. Request lines. Request line 4, that seems like it's enabled. That's our interrupt mask register. And it would seem that the mask is already enabled. So, where's that stuff that we don't need? What is AH here? Bit mask for 8259 RQ4 enabled. So that's FF minus 10. Oh! That's completely different to what? Oh, it's a bit mask, so. And then I want to. End it with that. So if I do that, F8, end. Is this a mask of things that aren't supposed to be running? Okay, let's just, for now, let's just say it's going to be E8. And then we're going to set the register that. Is this Christmas music? It would seem like Christmas music. Okay, let's see. Out AL 21. Why are you not doing that? 21H. What? Oh, it's reversed. Which is also what? Okay, so enabling the interrupt mask doesn't seem to help. Can I set AL? What is AL? Oops. I'm getting mind blown. Window, edit, registers. What's the help? Okay, I want to do control R, I think, yeah. No, that doesn't help. Okay. AL has got to be the low part, which is to the right, which is forever going to confuse me. Hmm? That's where it freezes? Oh, what? Oh, I didn't multiply it by 4. I believe it's 48. Which seems to be 30. Yeah. 20, 30, same thing probably. Still nothing, but I'm optimistic. Busy loop. So I have set that interrupt handler. So it's not the interrupt mask. Setting the right bit to 0 enables the IRQ. So that would mean if I do that, just gonna FF minus 1 to 4. What is that? EF. So the correct thing to do there is to end it. Okay, so does this help? Doesn't hurt. So what else does this code do? So the interrupt should be firing. What is IODLY? Is it buffering the IO? RQ4. That sets the mask. Oh, hey, Tosading, T-Sodding, what's up? My mouth is inverted like a lemon, like Homer when he bites the lemon. No, it's inverted like Homer when he bites the lemon in The Simpsons. Okay, yes, I do... I do receive any IRQs. Each IRQ needs to be acknowledged to the PIC mainly by sending an EOI. So I need to send 020 to 020? Sure, whatever. Maybe it's actually just waiting for me to return from the handler. That could be it. That would be nice. What is... Comrade? Oh no. What is happening in my chat? Out. Okay. DOS. It's okay, we're all Zoomers here. DOS does support TCP/IP, but I'm not using it because I'm a boomer and or a zoomer. I don't know. I'm a 30-year-old boomer, except I'm not 30. Right now, I'm just using a serial port to communicate with it, and I'm figuring this is probably a better idea because then I don't have to import the TCP/IP stack into DOSBox. I don't have to set up any networking on my computer. And it means I can just... Yes, a serial port. It means I can just then... connect it transparently and have TLS. Which is good. You gotta have the TLS for your bots. Don't be like the Twitch tutorials which say don't use TLS on your bots. You gotta have it. Or SSL. Is that what people still call it? You need to have out be 2020. That's what I'm doing. I have to enable the... What is this? What is A1? I don't understand this. This is trash. What is A1? A1? It's probably in here. A1, PIC2 data. I don't want to do anything with the PIC2 because I don't care. I'm doing stuff with the PIC1. Do I have to AND it or set it to zero? Okay. There's the command line, it's 20, master pick is 21, RQ 0 to 7, vector offset, intro numbers. Vector offset? Oh, I see. Pick one command, pick EIO. EOI. Pick one command. That's 20. And I am sending that out to 20. Why are you not telling me what to pick? Okay, so that should be 20 as well. I'm gonna set that to 2020. Nope. Okay. That's okay, I am just very angry. Slash, not angry at all. It's kind of a mix here. Moncaz, is that an emote that is not here? I don't know how Twitch emotes work. Is that a... okay. Is that a meme? You know what one of my favorite memes is? Long cat. That cat goes on forever. You have no idea. Okay. I'm not using protect mode. Interrupt processor. It's a bitmap of the request lines. When a bit is set, the pick ignores the request and continues normal operation. So I don't want to set it. So I have my bit mask. So this really should be setting it. 1, 4. And that should definitely be, yep, RQ4. Browser extensions are pretty cool. One, two, three, four. Okay. So I'm just going to run in AL again and just run that under the debugger. Just to super duper confirm this. Confirm this. F8, E8. Is that what I want? F8 and E8. In E8. F8 and EF, that gives me E8. Yes. Okay. Okay, so that seems to work. Port. Pick one data. Yes, that does seem to be the correct port. Pick 1 plus 1, that's 21. Okay. Okay, so I'm just gonna say that the interrupts are set fine. Something else is wrong. Tell the 8259 about it. Yep, I did that. Add 7 to the port number. Move that to 5555. What is IODLY? That seems important. Oops. IO delay. Is my internet dying? I don't want my internet to die right now. Where is IODLY? Oh, it's in term dev. Nop. Okay, let's just put a few nops in there. Sure, whatever. Does that help? It does not help. This concerns me. Definitely add the mask together. I send it to the correct output. I read it in to make sure. No, that code should be fine. Then I set the interrupt handler for 30. And COM3 is definitely 30. What if DOSBox wants it to be on COM1? Could that be what's happening? Let's just exit this for a little bit. It shouldn't be, but I don't know anymore. Yep, should be at PDS4. So what am I doing in my handler? All the things that I should be doing. Is my CLI and STI messing something up? Did I do that wrong? CLI zeroes it. STI sets it to 1. That should be fine. Okay, that's a good point. I should try to call it myself. What is it? It's 33. 30H. Is it? What's 30 divided by 4? 0 times C. Okay, so calling it does actually work, which means it's not being fired. Maybe it's because I'm modifying registers. Let's push some registers then. Push X, pop X. Am I in hell? It feels like I'm kind of in hell. Let's just double check this code. So it unmasks. E8. It definitely unmasks it, I think. STI. Oh. Let's see. Sets off the interrupt. Let's have a look again at this code. Thank you. What's the keyboard handler's interrupt? 09. Okay, so the keyboard IQ is firing. So this has to be something to do with me not starting up the serial line. Oh yeah. I guess that's working. To communicate with the serial port in interrupt mode, the interrupt enable register must be set correctly. I have not done that. Okay, let's probe some memory. Get around to here. Three F eight. Oh, these are the I.O. ports. Okay. 3F9. So, do I want to move? gonna move something to 3F9. Let's get out of here. I want to know when there's data available, so let's just send one. 3F9. And we're going to shove that in it. Value out of range. What are you telling me? What are you saying? That's the IO port. Why you gotta be like that? I don't understand. Do I need to put out the illegal instruction? One, 3F8, that's 9. Not B, 3F9. Value out of range, I'll put you out of range. Oh, it needs to be register. Okay, I got this. I've used a register once or twice in my life. Nope. Nothing but noodles. I can feel it getting close. You what? Okay, let's see. Okay, line particle. Okay, so I have to set the D-lab. Yeah, so we throw 80 at DLAB. Now I'm just going to wrap this all in stuff to stop interrupts because my code is nothing but spaghetti at this point. Move AL 80, so that's the lab register. And then we want to set that. What is port plus 4? What's my divisor going to be? Be 9? Yeah, I think so. DXL. So we're instead gonna set the DLAB to 3. What do I need 5 for? I'll just skip that for now. Why not? Yeah. Oh! That makes sense too. If I'm not setting the register to be ready, then it's not going to loop back. I gotcha. What's the FA plus 4? So yeah, FC. Is this gonna work? Possibly? Nope. Might need to set the FIFO. Plus 1. 80. I'll just set that to 3. That should be plus 1. 0. Plus 1 should be 0. Okay, so plus 2. That's going to have to be C7. What's 3FA plus 2? Or is it plus 3? Wait. So that should be... Yeah, okay. Let's try that then. Let's just not disable all interrupts. In fact, I want interrupts. Just throw 6 of that. And that should be it. Good thing I checked myself before I Shrek'd myself. What's the line? Motion control. Interrupt identification and FIFO control registers. So that should be plus 2. Why is plus 4 indicating that it can do interrupts? Modem control register. What is this writing to the modem control register? 87H. plus two. Seven, so let's try going with 8, 7 for that. Maybe the port. Oh, all right. Modem control. That's the X4. And that should be that. B. Yeah, okay, I'm setting that. These mod lines. Let's read the code again. Disable the interrupts there. Maybe that's a bad idea. Should disable them instead of the handler. My god. Okay. Maybe we actually do need to disable the classical interrupt. Zero D. Let's try that by just debugging. I have to not activate the FIFO. Where does it set the divisor? Does it? Stuff. or nothing. Has it not there, so let's just see what it does. Then it goes straight to +4. Is that really 87? Set the interrupt. It is assembly agent PN. I'm trying to initialize the serial port so I can get interrupts from it. I don't know anymore. Is there anything worth living for if not assembly? But I have some code here that's telling me how to do it. I just have to understand it first. StaRpauSe825 interrupt mask. Yes, I've enabled the interrupt. Com 1 is 358. So by writing to port 1. Oh, do you usually program in something else than assembly? Are there, like, C, Python? Maybe I should activate the firework first. Ooh, PowerShell. How's that going? I've tried it on Windows a bit, but it's been a little annoying. That's offset two. H. Active Directory work, huh? That sounds kind of terrible. But also, Active Directory is kind of cool, isn't it? I live in the Linux world, so I don't know too much about Active Directory. Okay, so that sets up the FIFO. Out DXL. According to this, it should work, but it doesn't. Unless it's that. Not sure yet. Probably chat to people. Mod lines. I might connect it to another serial port and have it do something cool, like change music. Surely if I like set the serial port up, then it will be fine, and it'll be easy to add more serial ports. Okay, line protocol. Baud rate. How are the Arduinos, how are you communicating with them? If it's over serial line, then probably. It depends what you're running on your Arduino. Okay, I'm 90% sure that this is lies. This is lies. And I'm gonna read something else on it. DOSBox. No, wait. DOS enable serial port. I feel like I'm missing something terribly, terribly obvious. Okay. F8, E8, E8. In that. So that day 7, 3 of 8, 2. I would help, but that's the only program I ever almost failed. Programming in DOS, or... Look, it says boob. Yeah. Isn't that funny? Out DXL. Okay, so STI. I don't know what anything is anymore. I think I've questioned my life enough. Let's see. Is it the CLI and STI? Is that what's doing it? Test to it. Oh no. I'm getting really tired and giggly from this. Ooh. I have absolutely no idea why this code is zero working. There's zero working left. I cannot comprehend why this would not work. Okay, let me just do a quick test. Type com1, and this should get me stuff, right? Type com1. If I do that. Oops. Okay, so when it wants to read from the port, it can. But it's just not interrupting. It's not firing interrupts. I have a feeling the only way to fix this is to quickly read DOSBox's source code. I don't know if that's cheating, but I'm gonna do it. So, let's find DOSBox's source code. Backtrace. Break read. Backtrace. Continue. Backtrace. Continue. Backtrace. Okay, let's do break that. Listing, let's just write port, port handle, data. Okay, let's just quickly continue this. And oh no, it's already running my program, so it's set stuff up. Okay, break, serial get car. Alright, now let's just step through this. So it reads the data. Okay, read something. What did it read? T. All right. Next instruction. So it receives it. What next? It quits. Oh no. If a value, it does receive byte X. Okay. Do receive RX weight, set event, serial RX event. So let's just quickly hop over to DOSBox's code. So RX event. Yep. What does it do then? If it can receive a byte, it sets the event. Your RX event, but it just set that event. Do receive, is that what it's calling? Receive. Receive byte X. Serial port.cpp Yeah, delete that. Receive. I can spell receive properly, I swear. So what does it do? A byte was received. Add B. No, I do not accept this. This has to do some interrupt. IRQ. Serial default RQ, yep, accept that probably. Serial. Did it do that when it started the program? Did it give me the serial debug stuff? No. Okay, that's not very helpful. Right handler i.install. Okay. What is a right handler? And what is I plus base? What is base? Serial base address. Three F eight. Okay, that's what I'm using at the moment. So that's good. Right handler, serial write. Oh no, I'm using serial read. This has got to fire it. An IRQ, doesn't it? Activate IRQ. Compute IRQ. Okay. What's compute interrupts do? Is that called all the time? Okay, that seems like that's what I want to hook into. Continue. Here we go. Of course, it's going to optimize that out. Alright. Waiting interrupts. Okay. Next. Next. What's val? 25. Error priority. Timeout priority. If val and it's not active. You what, mate? Why are you not activating? Oh, it might be activated already, IRQ active. Okay, that's RQ. Pick underscore activate RQ. Let's have a look. and what that would do. Source hardware pick. Oh, run IQs. Start RQ. So let's actually go to run IRQs. Pick underscore run IRQs. Let's see, what IRQs do I have enabled? I have to get to line 305 before that. Active RQ is optimized out? Why? Why would you do that? Priority active RQ. RQs. Oh, is this it? And we want to be at RQ 7, I believe. 4. Masked false, active equals false. My dude. Okay, what if I choose 4.active equals true? What if I do that? Nothing. Pick. Start RQ. Okay, so it's not actually calling IRQ, start IRQ is 4. Which must mean... that it's not active. So that sets up the pick. My God. I think I'm just dead inside at this point. Activate IRQ. What if I do this? Oh. That worked. So how do I activate, how do I get it to activate the IRQ? Oh, so active doesn't mean it's ready. So only the serial part will actually do that. So why isn't that being called? Again, it's that compute interrupts that we seem to be having a problem with. Val is 25. Ugh. Is RQ active? What's up to? Oh no. No. Okay, well, this might actually be a fitting end. No, it is. It is not yet. If up to. Temp op 2 equals true. What's op 1? Kind of working. What if I just set F0. Does that help? It works the first time, but not the second time. Maybe it's because I'm reinitializing it. Oh, DOSBox. What are you doing? Memcia op 1 mask. What's the underscore DSR? Why is MSR behind you? So what if I do this? Int.com and then I just don't touch anything here. Oh, I see. Okay, well, how about instead of doing that, I just start with 64 and I decrement it. And I do jump not equals. I'll just kill that because I think it has a broken interrupt handle there. Okay, then let's just click, look at 014F. And let's pipe something to it. I'll have to figure out how exactly to fix that tomorrow. But as far as I'm concerned, I've made progress today. I mean, I got interrupts to work. That's something. Most of it is me getting annoyed because my DOSBox hack that I did at the start of the stream turned out to break things. Oh well. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Remember, I don't know. There's nothing to learn here. Don't use DOS. That's what you should learn.